when CJ was born, between, I guess, 2 to 5 years of age, he started having crisis. She had a stroke. Strokes are one of the main killers of persons with sickle cell anemia. As soon as we found out, you know, we immediately began having those conversations, you know, with doctors and with, you know, hematology and oncology, you know, about what lies ahead. And I want to say, if he was not the first bone marrow transplant for sickle cell, he was one of the first here at the hospital. All the siblings did volunteer to be tested to see if they were compatible to be his transplant.
To have our children, which, you know, now they're grown, but in younger, to want to give of themselves, it really made us as parents very proud.
His sister Janae was 100% sibling donor, which was awesome. So now we're prepared to come. As we're walking out the door with his little Transformers backpack, and he's a little boy and he's looking up to his father, he looks up to me and says, "Daddy, am I gonna die?" And I'm like, wow. And I don't hesitate. I say really quick, "No, son, you're going to be just fine. You're going to be all right." But in the back of my mind, I don't know. We're believers that that God was going to bring us through. And so we got in the car, we came here, got here, and just got the best care, the best treatment, and had the most wonderful journey.
The doctors, the nurses, the therapists, even the persons who come into the rooms to clean, everyone, they treated us as if we were their only patient.
I had my bone marrow transplant at 7 or 8. I've actually been doing well, doing boxing, track, cross country.
When Zoe was diagnosed with sickle cell anemia, she was the first. She had fetal hemoglobin in her system. It apparently helped her not have symptoms of sickle cell.
Up until about 14, I would just have these backaches here and there whenever something was too cold. And so I would have to kind of be tiptoeing around all the time, just being very cautious of what I did. When the idea of bone marrow transplant was brought up to me and talking about how I could get rid of sickle cell for good, the idea was overwhelming, but also it kind of felt like it would give me a second chance at life. Post-transplant, I literally have not had any signs or symptoms of sickle cell, even a trace of sickle cell being in my body, knowing that I won't have to deal with these pain crises, and I feel like I'm living more freely. It's just all around just 100% better.
What I would tell families who are going through this process, definitely keep the faith. Get yourself a support system. Make sure you educate yourself concerning disease. There is hope now. There are new treatments now. There is medication now, and that you're not alone.